So dear students, in our last section we have seen what is clustering with the example. Now we will see the things that are necessary, that are parts of the clustering, that is points, spaces and distance, which we have these words we have heard when we have talked about the clustering techniques. So the database or data set suitable for clustering is collection of points, means the objects are belonging to some space. Then the data set which is suitable for clustering is nothing but collection of points where these objects are belonging to some space. So now what is this space? So space is a set of points from which all the points in the data set are drawn. Means what I want to say, that these particular topics or the things that are related to each other, that is point, space and distance. So what is point? Point is data set suitable for clustering is nothing but collection of points. Now which are these points? So the set of points from which the points in the data set are drawn is called as space, and all spaces for which we can perform a clustering should have the distance measure giving a distance between any two points in the space. So in general, a space is universal set of points from which the points in the data set are drawn. However, we should be mindful of the common case of Euclidean space. Euclidean space we have seen in our last sections. So whenever we are talking about normal space, so it's nothing but the Euclidean space which has number of important properties that are useful for clustering. That's why we are considering the Euclidean space. So in particular, a Euclidean space points are nothing but what? They are nothing but the vector of real numbers. So the length of the vector is number of dimensions of the space. The components of the vector are normally called as coordinators of the represented points. So these are nothing but the vectors that are represented in Euclidean space. And what is length? Length is nothing but dimensions of that space. So all spaces for which we can perform a clustering should have a distance measure, as I said. So it should have the distance measure. What it will give? It will give us the distance between two points that are present in the space. We can see over here, these are the unorganized objects, and by using point, space and distance we are able to build the cluster. How? For that we are doing these collection of points. We are utilizing the space where these collection of points are considered, and by using what? These collection of points are considered into particular group by using the distance measure. So the common Euclidean distance, that is nothing but square root of sums of squares of differences between the coordinates of the points in each dimension, that we have seen already. So the common Euclidean distance is used whenever we are talking about the distance measure. We can use the Manhattan distance also. What was Manhattan distance? It was nothing but the sum of magnitude of difference in each dimension. But generally when we are talking about the Euclidean space, the Euclidean distance is considered. So when we are talking about Euclidean space, we can consider the Manhattan distance as well as L distance also. But according to the requirement, we are considering the particular distance. So generally clustering is conceptual clustering also, where two or more objects belong to the same cluster. If this defines the concept common to all objects, so objects are grouped according to their fit, means objects are grouped according to what is the property that is common in between them. So what is the goal of using these clustering methods? So the goal behind using clustering method is to determine the intrinsic grouping in a set of unlabeled data. So in general we can say that the goal of clustering is to reduce the amount of data by categorizing or grouping the similar data items together. Means what is the goal? We are reducing the amount of data. How? We are categorizing same data together. So now how to decide what constitutes a good clustering? So for this, our aim should be in such a way that it should contain the elements that are having the same features. So such grouping is pervasive in the way human process information, and one of the motivations for using clustering algorithms is to provide the automated tools. It is the main aim that it provides the automated tools to help in constructing the categories. So we could be interested in finding the representative for homogeneous groups. So that is nothing but data reduction. So for this we are finding the natural clusters. Now natural clusters means we are trying to find the useful properties so that we can be able to suitable grouping to do the suitable grouping. That is the main goal of clustering methods. So that the reduction of amount of data should be there, and the work should be done in such a way that we should be able to have the constructive categories by using the clustering. So this was about the point space distance which is used in clustering and the goals of using clustering methods. In our next section, we will see which are the possible applications of clustering. Thank you.